Hi, welcome to excelrush.com. Today we are going to learn how to restrict duplicate data entry in a column. So let's say we are making a list of passport numbers of travelers. The first passport number that you put is this. The second passport number that you put is this. After putting the two passport numbers, by mistake, if you enter the first passport number again, it should not allow you. That is the objective. So how we will do this is, we will select all the cells in that column after the header. We don't want to include the header. Go to the data tab. Go to an option called data validation. In that, in allow, you take custom because we want to put a very specific criteria which is there in our mind. And the formula is going to be Countifs. First, we are going to put $E. E is the column where we are entering our data. $2. 2 is the row number from where the data is starting up till E2. That's the range. Comma, the criteria is also E2 itself. And that should be less than equal to 1. What does this formula mean? That it is going to check from E2 to E2 in the first cell, and if the criteria is that itself, the count is going to be 1. Let me explain you this little differently in a simpler manner. Now, first we will apply this and check. So we say okay, the condition has got applied. Let's try and enter the same data again. It is going to reject it. If you enter something different, it is going to accept it. If you try to enter the same data again, it's going to reject it. So let's see what the formula was. We did a Countifs $E$2, which is this cell, up to E2. So what this means is, when we'll copy this formula down, the first $E$2 is not going to change because of the dollar signs. So we are always saying start the range from E2. Till where? Till wherever the copied formula is. I'll show you that as well. Comma, check for that itself as the range, and that we are checking if it is less than equal to 1. So let's just get the count. When we do this, we get a count 1, which means the first passport number is available once. We copy this down. We get that the second passport number is also available 1. Let's see the formula. The $E$2 did not change, but E2 became E3, and again E2 became E3. So now in this cell, it is checking from E2 to E3, how many times is E3 available in the data. Now we had put less than equal to 1 as the condition. What would this mean? That it is going to allow only the count up to 1. So either 0 or 1. If it is more than 1, it's going to reject it. Hence, it is able to identify if it is a duplicate and reject it. Thank you for watching.